Online whiteboards are a great tool for remote collaboration. Team can share their ideas, do brainstorming, SWOT analysis, design sprints, project management, and much, much more, all in real-time, simultaneous collaboration. There are so many whiteboard tools available. You will be inspired by a high-level overview of the existing tools, so that you can go and try them and choose the one that best suits you. And you will get a list of all the whiteboards that I know with a link to their webpage that I will post in the description here below. And if you want to know which is my favorite whiteboard tool, then watch the video till the end. There are a number of features that whiteboards may or may not offer, and that you may or may not need. This is the list that I will use to compare all the different tools. I'll start from the simplest whiteboards, like the Zoom and Teams built-in ones, to then move on to the more feature-rich ones, like Miro or Mural. Let's get started. Let's start from the simplest solution, the built-in Zoom whiteboard. From within a Zoom meeting, we access it by clicking on Share Screen and then Whiteboard. It has fixed dimensions and we can't zoom in. If we run out of space, we can add multiple pages. The tools panel can be moved around. The available tools are pretty limited. I'll try now to handwrite and see how it feels. I'm doing that with an Intuos Wacom tablet. It's okay, but pretty basic. Let's say I want to write it again in a different color. I can trash it, writing it in black, then select this kind of highlighter and use it to underline my writing. I will add some text in different colors and different sizes. And let's also try the stamps. We have arrows, checks, crosses, stars, hearts, and question marks. Let's draw a shape as a container and an arrow. I've also connected to the meeting with my iPad, and I will try to write with my finger on the iPad. I'll also highlight, put arrows. When a participant works on the board, we can see his name. The iPad experience is not too bad, the writing is really basic, but we actually have a few functions that are not available on PC. And let's clear the content. We can clear our content, or if we're hosts, we can clear the whole board. We can also save the board for future reference. All in all, the Zoom whiteboard is the simplest one, and the less feature-rich that is at the bottom of the ladder for me. The look and feel is not so great, and the experience is not so fluid. What you can do is actually pretty limited. The advantage is that it's built in Zoom. So if you are a Zoom user and have a Zoom subscription, then it's free. My recommendation is that you can use this board to share your notes, where you take care of the content and do your best to make it look good. And you ask participants to do little contributions, like adding stamps or writing some text. All in all, I think Zoom really needs to improve its board. The second board is the built-in whiteboard of Microsoft Teams. From within a Teams meeting, you just click on Share and then Microsoft Whiteboard. The board has an infinite canvas and we can zoom in and out. In the main control panel, we can choose the pen color as well as the brush thickness. And we can save four colors for quick access. There's a highlighter, eraser, we can insert text, and we have sticky notes, which we didn't have on Zoom. And then we can add shapes. If I try to write with my digital pen on the tablet, I can tell you that the feel is nicer, the experience is more fluid. There's only one text font available, but I already prefer it compared to the Zoom one. And we can resize and also rotate the text boxes. Let's add a sticky note and then a few shapes. We can change the outline and the fill color. How does it look on iPad? Again, the look and feel is more modern than on Zoom. We can draw with a finger and replicate well all the functions that we can do on PC. All in all, the built-in Teams whiteboard is better than the Zoom one. It's much more fluid and intuitive than the Zoom board. The user experience is overall much better and less frustrating for participants. The other advantage is that if you open a whiteboard during a meeting, when you finish it, you can still access it in the team. The next option is the app version of the Microsoft whiteboard. You can download it from the App Store. Let's create a new board. As default, I have a yellow background, but we can change the color. Also, we can decide whether we want to have different types of grids in the background. Let's choose white and this type of grid. As you see, the look and feel is very similar to the built-in Microsoft Teams whiteboard, but we have many more functionalities. The writing feeling is similar to the Teams whiteboard. On the right, we can define settings and we'll look at them in a moment. We can insert text, and if we are working with a digital pen, then we can use it to type on this digital keyboard. Participants can give a thumb up reaction to each of the objects, and the total number of reactions will be displayed on the object itself. We can resize the text and also rotate it. There's a snap to grid function that I find quite helpful. With the lasso, we can select one or more objects to resize them or move them together. And then there is a ruler tool that helps us drawing straight lines. Similar to Teams whiteboard, we can add sticky notes, add a reaction, and change their color. We can import images from our PC or from the web, add a note grid, a list, a to-do or a follow-up list. And then we can choose from many interesting templates that will help us running our meetings more effectively, like a weekly meeting planner or a brainstorming template. As you see, the whiteboard is not just made for the facilitator to share notes, but it's a true team collaborative tool. We can also add PDFs and select a page from a specific PDF and add other documents. Let's now review a couple of other cool functions. The first one is ink to shape. If we hand draw a shape, the software will recognize what we wanted to draw and turn it into a perfect shape. And voila! Oops, it didn't recognize the thin rectangle. The other function is ink to table. If we want to insert a table, we just draw a rectangle and then cut it in two vertically or horizontally, and automatically cells will be built. And here we have our table built in no time. Cool! Let's zoom out and have a look at everything we've done. The experience from the iPad is also very good and fluid, and we can replicate very well what we do on PC. All in all, the Microsoft Whiteboard is great. It's free if you have an Office 365 account. It offers many tools for true team collaboration, and I think it's the go-to whiteboard if you want to start using this kind of tools. You can use it on Teams meeting as well as on Zoom just by sharing the screen, and you can invite participants to join you on the board. It already has many cool functionalities, and honestly, I recommend you start from here and see if it already fulfills your needs before you invest money into more complex boards. I give for granted that all the following platforms have a mobile app and a good mobile experience. The fourth platform is the Miro Board. You can go to miro.com and create a free account. The free account has limitations, but it's good to test the platform. As we start a new board, we are proposed a number of templates. Meetings and workshops, brainstorming and ideation, agile workflows, mapping and diagramming, research and design, strategy and planning, and much, much more. Let's choose Icebreaker as an example. The board has an infinite canvas and we can zoom in and out. There are three command panels, one on the left, one at the bottom, and one at the top. Let's start from the left one. There's the selection tool, and then we find templates. By clicking here, we can access the templates that we've just seen. The nice thing is that multiple templates can be used within a single whiteboard, and once inserted, those templates are fully customizable. If, for example, we decide on the spot that we want to run a voting session, we can insert the dot voting template, assign a dot color to each participant, and start the voting session. We can add a text with different available fonts, change the color, insert links, format it, add shapes, sticky notes, arrows, there's a pencil, highlighter, and also here we find the smart drawing, where the software recognizes the shape that we want to draw and converts it into a smart object. Let's move to the left to create some space. I'm writing with the digital pencil and try different thicknesses. The writing feels quite good. We can use the lasso tool to select everything and, for example, change the color. A function we haven't found so far is the comment one. We can click on any part of the board and add a comment. Choose the color and activate the bell to receive notifications if somebody is responding to the comment. We can also add reactions with tone of emojis to each object. Once the comment is not relevant anymore, we can mark it as resolved. Another nice tool is the possibility of adding built-in frames, for example, a mobile or a desktop. We can change the orientation, change the fill color, or decide to import an image from the web. Here I looked for Maldives images and use it as a background. Let's now have a look at the bottom panel. Frames shows us all the frames that we're using in the whiteboard. That can be handy in case we have a large whiteboard with lots of frames. Then if we've inserted images, we can also go to presentation mode, where Miro displays images as slides. And we can check all comments. There is a chat function for internal team communication. We can share the screen. There are then a few options that are not available on the free plan. There's the voting, the internal video chat, and the timer. And here we have a record of all activities that were performed on the board. Let's move to the top, where we find reactions, like thumbs up, hearts, and other emojis, setting options, raise hand in case somebody wants to ask a question, and then the share button to invite people. Miro integrates with many, many apps for a smooth workflow. The board can be saved as image, as PDF, as a template, as well as a few other options. Let's see how much it costs. The good thing of Miro is that there is a free plan, which is the one that I'm working on right now. Features are clearly limited, but they allow you to do already great stuff. There's a team, business, and enterprise plan. The team one is for a minimum of 2 members and costs $16 a month. If we increase the number, say to 10 members, then it will cost $80 a month. You can also have collaboration with guest editors, when anyone with the link can edit the board. However, guest editors are anonymous. If you want to control exactly who accesses the board and who makes which changes, then you have to purchase daily passes. This costs $3 per user, and the option is available on the consultant and business plan. I don't think this is really straightforward, so if you're interested in purchasing a Miro subscription, I recommend you go check the details. Let's now move to Miro's biggest competitor. That is Mural. Mural, like Miro, has tons of templates, which I'm sure will fill all your needs. The board is relatively similar to Miro's one, with controls at the left, bottom, and top. Mural, however, doesn't have infinite canvas. You can zoom in and out, but the canvas size is limited and can be increased to a maximum of 6K by 6K pixels. Let's start reviewing the functions. We can add titles, text, comments, and the nice thing is that we have different sizes and shapes of sticky notes. In face-to-face facilitations, I like to use different types of sticky notes. And this replicates the reality very closely. I start adding brainstorming as a title and resize it. There's a nice lens function that centers the board to the object. We can choose among different fonts and colors, choose a background color. Let's now add some text and a comment. There is a little number that appears in the comment. And that is the number of contributions to that comment. So if you write a comment and then somebody writes a reply, then you'll see a 2. I like the round sticky notes, where I can change color and outline as well as the shape. A cool feature of Mural is that we can use connectors. These are lines or arrows that connect 2 objects. Once placed, the 2 objects remain connected. And that's very handy to link ideas and keep the connection if we need to move them around the board. We can add shapes, and then we have a number of very cool icons that we can resize and format. We can insert pre-built frameworks. There's pretty cool stuff in here, like this empathy map. It doesn't fit the canvas, so I have to move it. I actually don't understand why they don't have an infinite canvas. Or this business model canvas template from Strategizer. In the top right, we can click on share to invite participants and decide which rights we want to give to them. View only or can edit. We can export the board, chat with other participants, preview the comments in list format, and if we click on a comment, we're pointed straight to the relevant part of the board. There's the activity log, and now let's look at the bottom. There are 3 types of reactions. A very cool one is celebrate, that drops lots of confetti over the board. Then the plus button replicates the share function that we just saw. At the top, we have the voting session option, which we were not able to see in Miro because it was not part of the free plan. We can give a name to the voting session, assign a number of votes to each participant, and then start the vote. At the top, you see that I still have 3, then 2, then 1, then 0 votes left. And when I click on an object, you see the number of votes going up. And we can end the voting session. We then review a summary of all votes. There's a private mode. And then there's also a timer that can be useful for certain type of activities, like for example the voting. That was the Mural board. Let's now look at the available plans. What you've just seen is the full version of Mural, with no limitations. However, I'm on a free trial. At the end of the free trial, you have to upgrade if you don't want to lose your work. Different from Miro, where you can keep your free account work on three boards for all the time you want, here you need to upgrade. There are two plans, the Starter at $12 per month and the Plus at $20 per month. Starter is for medium teams up to 50 members and Plus is for larger teams. The nice thing compared to Miro is that you can have unlimited visitors and you can decide whether you want visitors to be anonymous or register with a name, so you have full control on who's accessing the board without having to pay the daily passes. Similarly to what I said with Miro, if you're interested in Mural, you should look at the details of the different type of users and make sure that they respond to your needs. I just spent one more minute on a whiteboard that has something different compared to the other ones. That's Explain Everything. It's much more focused on the drawing part, it offers lots of nice illustrations, and the possibility of recording the whole session and editing it. So if you're into explainer videos, this may be a tool to consider. And now, finally, let's go to my favorite, Klaxoon. Klaxoon is much more than a board. But to be fair, let's start with the board so we can compare it to the other ones. When we start the board, we can decide whether we want to give full control or limited control to the participants. Then we can decide whether we want to launch it with an access code or through a network. Yes, because in Klaxoon you can build a network of people with whom you can share different types of boards, but also other activities, as we will see later. Klaxoon has an infinite canvas board with controls at the bottom and at the top. As we did for the other boards, let's add some text, change the font, change the color. I have to say that the brush is very nice and probably this is one of the platforms where I prefer sketching, drawing or handwriting. We can add shapes, template frames, like for example this nice swot analysis. We can add sticky notes with different colors. When we select a sticky note, we have a few options. For example, we can ask a question linked to that note. And we have different types of questions, like rating, or yes, no, or we can associate a poll to it. I think that's very powerful. We can also add heart reactions to each object. We can take a snapshot that is saved as an image, insert images or sketches, search for content on the whiteboard, and then choose the options that best suit us. The grid snapping function, or inserting an image as a locked background. Klaxoon offers many templates. The content is similar to the one of Mural or Miro. The difference of Klaxoon is that it has a more playful style. You can do internal video chats, set a timer, and invite participants with an access code, or simply by asking them to scan the QR code. Now, why do I love Klaxoon? Because besides the board feature, it offers many more options. The question that we've seen before. You can do quizzes, surveys, and many more activities. All of this can also be part of a meeting. Participants, instead of joining just a board, they'll join a meeting, where a board can be one of the activities that you're running during that meeting. A cool feature is the adventure, that adds a little bit of fun and gamification. There are various themes that you can use, and you can add multiple milestones in the adventure. Participants gain points for each complete milestone, and you can share a leaderboard to create a little bit of fun and competition. Activities can be created on the spot during a meeting, and you also have stats that tell you the engagement of the meeting participants in each of the activities. There's an internal chat, and everything that's happening is reported in the meeting feed. With Klaxoon, you don't have to worry about different users or guests, as you decide whether you want participants to join with an email address creating an account or with a nickname. There's no free plan, and after you've completed your trial version, then you cannot keep using Klaxoon. There's a license just for the board that comes in 9.9 euros, but then you can access the full suite of applications at 12.9 euros per month. I think that's a fair price for all the things that you get.